Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 13, practice test 4, section 4, calculator allowed, found in the new SAT official study guide. So, the population of mosquitoes in a swamp is estimated over the course of 20 weeks as shown in the table, right? Which of the following best describes the relationship between time and the estimated population of mosquitoes during the 20 weeks? Okay, so first of all, notice that with increase in time, you have increasing population, right? So definitely decreasing and exponential decay must be wrong, right? Decay means something decreasing, right? Decreasing in size as time progresses. So decay and decreasing must be incorrect. So either choices A or C, right? So let's see. So it says increasing linear for choice A. Well, let's see what's going on. So you see that time is given in increments of 5 weeks, right? So for every 5 weeks, the population increases by a factor of 10, right? Because 100 times 10 is 1,000, 1,000 times 10 is 10,000, 10,000 times 10 is 100,000, and 100,000 times 10 is 1 million, right? So notice that if you calculate your slope using 1005 and 100 and 0, or well, sorry, 0 comma 105 comma 1000, if you calculate your slope, it's not going to be the same as the slope that you calculate based on these two guys, 5 1000 or 10 and 10000. Right, but even if you didn't know that, even if you use another method, I can recommend you to eyeball it, right? Because a factor of 10 should immediately tell you that it cannot be increasing linear, right? Because linear means for every 5 weeks you will have 900 population increase based on these first 2 points. So that means the same thing should happen here. The next point should have been 10 and 1900, but instead it's 10,000. So every time you think of factor of something as an increase of 1.1 population size with respect to another in a different time period, you know for sure that it cannot be linear, right? So you know for sure that it's exponential growth. You don't have to build a function to understand it, right? You can understand what the values represent. You can understand the differences of the values, right, for different time periods. And then you can estimate that it must be exponential growth. Right, exponential, because a factor of 10 implies exponential growth, right? Not linear growth, but exponential. So answer choice C is the correct answer choice in this problem.